regenerative medicine, stem cell therapy. They're both making big strides in the longevity community, and I recently got a chance to experience for myself what all the buzz is about. And I can't wait to share this incredible ride with you. One of the fields or disciplines, right, within longevity science that is currently offering a lot of promise is regenerative medicine. Now, this is an emerging field of medicine that seeks to regenerate or restore cells and tissues to a more functional and youthful state. And one of the big guns in regenerative medicine is stem cell therapy. Now, I recently had an opportunity to travel down to Costa Rica to have stem cell therapy done at Regenerative Medicine Institute, also known as RMI. Now, I've been back for about a month, and honestly, I can't wait to share my experience with you. In today's video, we'll be talking about what stem cell therapy is and why I decided that I needed it. My experiences at RMI, the procedures I had done, and the other therapies that RMI has available, and we'll talk about the report that I got back with my test results and RMI's recommendations. And finally, we'll take a look at the results that I've experienced in the last month since I've returned from Costa Rica. But before we get too far into this, I want to be upfront with you guys. RMI is not sponsoring this video. They're not paying me to mention them, and I'm not their affiliate. So this is going to be an honest representation of my opinion and experience with Regenerative Medicine Institute. Now, in all transparency, RMI did hire me to produce an educational video about the RMI experience for their patients, but that's another project, and it's not related to this video or to my channel. Now, you might be asking yourself, what's stem cell therapy? And why does this guy think he needs it? So let's tackle those questions first. Stem cell therapy is gaining in popularity, and there are a lot of clinics performing stem cell therapies. But the type of stem cell therapy that's performed can vary from clinic to clinic. One form of therapy utilizes stem cells that have been harvested from umbilical cords. Other clinics might collect the stem cells from your own body, and your own stem cells are called autologous stem cells. Some do liposuction, where they harvest adipose tissue and collect the stem cells from that. Other clinics might get the stem cells from harvesting bone marrow. The process that they used at RMI was to put me on a course of a drug called Neupogen to activate the release of stem cells from my bone marrow into the bloodstream. They then put me on a machine that filtered those stem cells out of my blood. However stem cells are harvested, these cells are then prepped in one form or another and then reintroduced through infusion or injection. These stem cells can then repair damaged tissues in a couple of different ways. One way is that as different types of tissue cells die off within our own bodies, they're replaced by stem cells, which become that type of cell. Another way is by activating tissue repair by releasing exosomes, which are chemical messengers that go to the damaged tissue and issue instructions activating tissue repair within the cell. Either way, having a new source of stem cells can promote healing and repair throughout your body. And this is the basis for regenerative medicine. So, how did I decide that I needed to take advantage of this advance in longevity science? Well, I'm 72 years old, and I've got a lot of tissue that's not functioning as it should. I've got aches and pains that I didn't have as a younger man. My performance is starting to slip, whether it's in the gym or in the bedroom. My energy levels, they've dropped a bit over the years. And I've got injuries that just haven't healed properly. So why aren't my own stem cells enough to do the job? Well, one of the hallmarks of aging is called stem cell exhaustion, and it happens to pretty much everyone. As we age, the number of stem cells that are available to do the necessary repairs go into decline, like everything else. Now, the body's smart, and when we're young, there are repair processes in place to restore those stem cells, to repair them. But stem cells themselves get damaged. And here's the thing. Most of the stem cells in our bodies are quiescent, meaning that they're in a dormant state. Now, damage happens all the time, regardless of whether or not they're active or they're dormant. But the repairs of stem cells only happen once they've been activated. They don't happen when the stem cell is quiescent. So as we age, the damage to our quiescent stem cells accumulates, receiving more and more damage without being repaired. At the same time, our ability to repair the activated stem cells gradually decreases. These two factors will eventually result in the crossing of a threshold where once the stem cell is finally activated, there's just too much damage to overcome. The damage has become too great for our declining repair processes to fix. And those stem cells die because they're just not viable. And as they die, our pool of stem cells becomes smaller and smaller. This is stem cell exhaustion. So, given the opportunity, I decided to go down to Costa Rica and see what RMI could do for me. And here's the thing. They do more than just stem cell therapy. They do regenerative therapy. And they're not just trying to restore stem cell exhaustion. They're trying to rejuvenate and restore all the hallmarks of aging.
If we understand how the cells interact with each other from step one to the next step, which are the hallmarks, we could then look for interactions or how to intercede with those processes that gradually cause more and more deterioration and aging in cells. And so that's how what we've looked at RMI is to understand that process of how cells age from being young and healthy to where they can potentially turn into cancer and how we intercede.
They offer several procedures that have a lot of regenerative potential. Now, I'm going to go over the therapies that I received as well as a couple of therapies that I didn't to give you an idea of what RMI offers. The whole process kicked off about a month before I flew down to their facility. It started with me going to my local lab for the tests that RMI requested. They included a metabolic panel, kidney and liver function, cholesterol and lipids, a complete blood count or CBC, levels of free radicals, telomere length, an inflammation panel, a hormone panel, and a neurotransmitter panel. I was also sent True Diagnostics biological age test. Now, I've taken this test before, and I included the report in a video that I did, and I'm a big fan of True Diagnostic. So I was really interested to see where I stood and what might have changed since the last time I took their test. The final test that RMI required was another test that I could do from home, the Genova urine test, which tests for damage to the DNA. All these tests were to set a baseline, to get a picture of where I was before I started, so that I've got something I can compare future tests against. But on my own, I decided to do a couple more tests. I did Genfinity's aging SOS test to determine my load of senescent cells. I did an in-body body composition test to determine the percentage of my body fat. I also did Genfinity's intracellular NAD plus test to see where my NAD levels were. And once I was at the RMI clinic, they performed a couple more tests. One was a test called the PhysioAge test, which tests for physical functionality. It tests for cognition and memory, pulmonary and cardio function, and skin aging. They also conducted a sleep study using a device called the VivoScore, which is a ring, kind of like the Oura ring. So about a week before I flew down to Costa Rica, I started a 5-day round of senolytics provided by RMI. I took Ficitin and I took Dasatinib plus Quercetin to clear senescent cells from my body. Senescent cells are cells that have lived out their lives and are supposed to die off and be replaced by new cells, but they don't. Instead, they continue on, not functioning, but still metabolically active. And they can do a lot of damage, not the least of which is spewing out pro-inflammatory molecules that can induce neighboring healthy cells to become senescent, in addition to raising the level of chronic inflammation. Now, a paper just came out that demonstrates that when regenerative therapies are combined with senolytics, they're more effective than when either of these therapies are done alone. Now, this study was done on fruit flies, but it showed a lot of promise. And it backs up my theory that the more interventions you do, the better the results you'll get. Stem cells are also susceptible to becoming senescent. So the senolytics encourage a lot of senescent cells to just give up the ghost and die, where they are then disposed of by the immune system. Now, this clears the way for the regenerative procedures.
After I finished the senolytics,
I started a 3-day round of a drug called Neupogen. Neupogen is a drug that stimulates the growth of white blood cells in the bone marrow. It also stimulates the overproduction of stem cells at the same time, dumping them into the bloodstream. Now, this process is called mobilization, and it floods your bloodstream with new live stem cells ready for collection. In the middle of the Neupogen course, I flew down to San Jose, the capital of Costa Rica. Now, RMI is located in a district called Escazú, about 9 miles west of San Jose. Now, this is a pretty upscale area with a lot of shopping, hotels, and medical clinics. Medical tourism is a big part of the economy of Costa Rica. So my first procedure was the collection of my mobilized stem cells. They hooked me up to this machine called an apheresis machine that drew blood out of my left arm and then filtered out the stem cells and then returned the blood into my right arm. Now, this mobilization and collection process isn't just about harvesting stem cells. They only collect a fraction of the total number of stem cells that are mobilized. The rest of the stem cells, the ones that don't get collected, continue to circulate throughout the body, repairing and regenerating new tissue. And this is considered to be the first treatment, the mobilization and collection of stem cells. Although, when I think about it, I think that maybe the first treatment is when I cleared out the senescent cells, and the mobilization and collection might be the second treatment. At any rate, once my stem cells are collected, they're sent to their lab. Now, I gotta say right here, I got to visit RMI's lab. It's right across the street from their clinic. I got the tour and I was impressed. Most stem cell clinics either don't have their own on-site lab, or those that do have a very basic one. The lab at RMI is comprehensive, and the doctors that run the lab are among the best in their field.
Unable to have a stem cell clinic, you need to have a really good quality stem cell lab.
Right.
And it's really easy to take out fat or even your blood, stir it up and inject it back. But the rationale behind the cells has to come from the lab. The number of cells, the quality of the cells, a sterility test, all these things that we do here in the labs to certify that you're receiving a standardized product, I think is the key of the successful clinical treatment.
So one of the things that they do in the lab is that they count the number of stem cells that were collected during the apheresis process, and they determine the percentage of those stem cells that are viable. Now, on average, about 40% of the collected stem cells are endothelial stem cells, 55% are hematopoietic stem cells, and only 5% are mesenchymal stem cells. So RMI collects three types of stem cells, as opposed to most stem cell clinics that only collect one, usually adipose-derived stem cells. So let's talk for a minute about what these different types of stem cells do. The endothelial stem cells help to produce new vascular growth within the body. This is important for increased blood flow, and they can also help to repair vascular stiffening. Hematopoietic stem cells are progenitor stem cells for all types of blood cells, and these stem cells can reinvigorate the immune system, increasing the number and health of white blood cells. And the mesenchymal stem cells are used to repair and regenerate new muscle and organ tissues. One of the services that RMI offers is that they take these collected stem cells and they go into the stem cell vault, where they're cryopreserved at minus 80 degrees centigrade. Now, that's about minus 112 degrees Fahrenheit. Numerous studies have shown that in cryopreservation, stem cells can remain viable for at least 25 years and probably much longer. It's just that 25 years is the longest study that's been done so far. Now, this is the bank of stem cells that I'll be drawing on for years to come. Every time I go down to receive more of my own stem cells, this is where they'll come from. And I only have to go through this procedure a single time. They collect enough stem cells to last through 40 to 50 years of annual stem cell infusions of around 100 million cells each. All right, so that's the collection process. Since only about 5% of the mobilized stem cells are mesenchymal stem cells, the next day I got an infusion of mesenchymal stem cells that were sourced from umbilical cords. Now, I believe that this was so that the mobilized stem cells that they didn't collect, the ones that were still in my bloodstream, repairing and replacing damaged tissues, also included a healthy amount of mesenchymal stem cells. This process simply involved hooking me up to an IV for about an hour. Now, my last day in the clinic, I got a procedure that I was really excited about, and it was the last therapy that I got on this visit. I underwent about 3 hours of plasmapheresis. This is where they draw off your blood, centrifuge out this plasma, and then replace it with saline solution, to which some proteins in the form of albumin have been added. Now, this was done on the same machine that the collection was done on, and they replaced about 2 liters of my plasma. That's about 2/3 to 3/4 of the plasma in my body. Now, a therapy that I did not undergo, but that I expect to receive when I return in about 6 months, is their therapy for erectile dysfunction. Now, this involves both injections of stem cells along with shockwave therapy. And I'm told that this procedure has one of the highest success rates of any procedures that they do. Another therapy that RMI performs is an orthopedic procedure for those with joint issues, where they inject stem cells directly into the joint. Now, this procedure can alleviate a lot of joint pain that older individuals can experience, and it can potentially take the place of joint replacement surgery. Okay, so I've been back for about a month, and about a week ago, I got my report from RMI, and this included a Zoom consultation with a couple of their doctors. This report consists of their findings, the results of their testing that they did, and their recommendation to correct some problems that they found. So this is kind of interesting. First, the PhysioAge test. And some of these results seem a bit wonky. They put my cardiovascular age at 90 and my skin age at 87. Now, the cardio age was determined by looking at something called my augmentation pressure, which is determined by measuring what's called pressure wave reflection. Now, I think that's the same thing that a device called the iHeart measures. Now, I own an iHeart device. I test regularly, and it comes back with an age of between 42 and 55. Now, I talked with Dr. Giampapa about this, and he also thought that the result was unexpected and that we probably need to retest. So my skin age came back at 87, and I'm also questioning that. Honestly, I just don't feel like I've got 87-year-old skin, and it just doesn't seem that old to me. But my cognitive age came back at 40.6, and I'm thrilled with that. That feels about right. My pulmonary age came back at 67. Now, I did another functional test a couple years ago at RadFest, and that was called the age meter test, and it put my pulmonary age at 61. So I'm just not sure how accurate the PhysioAge test is. I also got back the results for my true diagnostic test. Now, I did this test about 9 months ago. The current test puts my biological age at 63.9 compared to 61.2 9 months ago. So it looks like I aged about 2.7 years in the last 9 months. But that same report states that I'm biologically aging at a rate of about 8/10 of a year for every year that I age chronologically. Now, if that were true, then it should have come in around 62 rather than almost 64. So again, there's some questions there. I think bottom line, biological age testing is an imperfect science. Things like DNA damage and markers for inflammation came back great. Telomeres are actually a bit longer than they were 9 months ago, so that's good. But here's the great news. I got back the report on how many stem cells they collected and the viability of those stem cells. The total number of my stem cells that they collected came back at almost 30 billion. Now, they're looking for numbers around 10 billion or better, and mine came back almost three times that number. They're also looking for a viability rate of 80% or better. That's the percentage of my stem cells that are healthy. And my viability rate came back at 98%. So I'm really happy with my collection. Now, I'm still waiting on the report for the sleep study, but one of the results came back right away. And this shows how testing and monitoring can have a huge impact on your longevity plan. I always thought that I slept like a baby and that I didn't suffer from sleep apnea. But the sleep study showed that I have around 19 sleep apnea events per hour. So this has shown me that I need some more work on my sleeping habits. Now, here's what I really like about RMI. In the report that they sent me, based on the testing that they did, they identified a number of issues. They identified a number of biomarkers that could be improved, areas in my longevity plan that need some work. And they made a list of recommendations to improve those areas. First off, they recommended that I take certain drugs and nutraceuticals to correct some problems that they found in testing. And they didn't just recommend them. They're sending those drugs and nutraceuticals to me. First off, they're sending me a proprietary nutraceutical called Healthy Cell to decrease DNA damage and improve the epigenome. They're sending another called AC11 to repair breaks in the DNA, and another to increase the length of my telomeres. They're also sending me metformin and sirolimus, which is a rapamycin analog. They're sending sildenafil, selegiline, and centrofenoxine to improve cognitive function. They're sending the senolytics dasatinib plus quercetin and fisetin. They're sending red yeast rice extract to lower my cholesterol and replace the statin that I'm taking. And they're sending collagen peptides and several creams and lotions to improve my aging skin. They also put together a weightlifting program for me that's appropriate for someone my age and with my experience at lifting weights. They'll be tracking my progress and making adjustments over time. Then in September, they'll be retesting me, building on that original baseline to determine the effectiveness of their therapies. Also, in September, I'll go back to Costa Rica to have my own stem cells reinfused. Remember, on my first visit, I was infused with mesenchymal stem cells that were harvested from umbilical cords. In September, they'll be reinfusing my own stem cells, which include endothelial stem cells and hematopoietic stem cells. I also expect to undergo the ED therapy and, you know, maybe some orthopedic therapy. All right, let's wrap this video up by examining an aspect of this therapy that I imagine most of you find the most intriguing. What are my results? How have I benefited? What improvements have I seen? Now, I gotta say right here, it's a little bit early. The benefits of stem cell therapy can continue to build for up to 6 months. Now, that said, I've been amazed by what I've seen so far. Now, I gotta admit, I was pretty skeptical at first, and I honestly didn't expect to see any results for at least a month, maybe two. But I've had this chronic pain in my lower back for about 10, maybe 15 years, and it seems to happen when I sleep. I wake up with this pain, and then it gradually gets better over the day. But when I woke up the first morning after my stem cell infusion, the pain was gone. It was something that I noticed immediately, and it hasn't come back. It's been over a month now, and it hasn't returned. So that's one thing, and actually kind of a big thing. I've also noticed a big shift in my performance while exercising. Now, I do Orange Theory, and by the end of class, I'm always wiped out, or I was. Not anymore. I've noticed that now Orange Theory seems almost easy. I guess I'm going to have to up my game. Now, I've also experienced weight loss. Now, at first, I was delighted, but then I got another in-body body composition test, and I realized that the weight loss was mostly muscle mass. I'd lost about 8 pounds of lean body mass and about 5 pounds of skeletal muscle, and I'd actually gained 3.7 pounds of fat. Now, the fat didn't really surprise me. I loved Costa Rican food, especially the fresh fish, and I ate pretty good while I was down there. But the loss of muscle mass surprised me. And I've been thinking about this, and I've discussed this with the good doctors at RMI. Now, they don't seem to be too concerned about it. And I did have about the same amount of lean body weight about 4 years ago. So I'm going to keep an eye on my lean body mass, and I'm going to go back to strength training to see if I can't regain that lost muscle mass. So at about a month out, I've actually seen a lot more improvement than I was expecting to see at the 1 month mark. And given their recommendations and the scheduled return to RMI for more infusions of stem cells, I imagine that I'll be seeing even more improvements over the next year. So I'll be making more videos to let you guys know not only what results I'll be seeing, but also how my biomarkers have improved. And that's it for this video. If you'd like to learn more about stem cell therapy or stem cell exhaustion, check out these videos. I'll catch you guys next time. I'm out of here.